Electricity and magnetism are interlinked, and the relationship between the two is fascinating. Electromagnets, transformers, motors, electric generators, all these are result of this relationship between electric current and magnetism. The linear motor on this table is also a result of that relationship between electric current and magnetic field. Before I demonstrate the working of this linear motor, let us peep into some wonderful discoveries made by a couple of scientists in 19th century. In 1821, Hans Christian Oersted, for the first time, demonstrated that current in the conductor produces magnetic field. It was a simple experiment. You'll get to see further into the video. You'll get to see that experiment. And 10 years down the line, in 1831, Michael Faraday demonstrated exactly the opposite, that changing magnetic field induces a current in the conductor placed in that changing magnetic field. Wonderful discoveries. These two discoveries have given rise to so many equipments that we use today, right from generation of electricity to transmission of electricity, its distribution, and the inventions like, as I said earlier, electric generator, motor, transformer, all work on these two effects. And I've made two videos earlier on these two effects, two separate videos, one showing Oersted's experiment, the other showing Michael Faraday's experiment. The link to these videos is in the description, but let us have a look at the clips from those videos, because understanding of these two effects is important in understanding the working of this linear motor. Here is the clip from the first video. Whenever there is current in that yellow wire, which is placed parallel to the magnetic needle deflects. If there is no current, the needle remains in its natural position, which is north-south direction of Earth. But whenever there is electric current in the yellow wire, the needle deflects, indicating that a magnetic field is generated around that yellow wire. This is the natural fact. Electric current produces magnetic field. And the opposite of this is seen in the second clip. Here you will see a coil is connected to a galvanometer. Galvanometer indicates current. It does not measure the current, but it indicates the presence of current. And right in the center, there is a magnet. As long as that magnet is stationary, not moving, the galvanometer shows zero deflection. The minute I start moving this magnet, the galvanometer shows some reading, some deflection. If I lift the magnet, the galvanometer deflection is in one direction. If I put the magnet back, the deflection is in opposite direction. Amazing, isn't it? Electric current produces magnetic field, and changing or varying magnetic field produces current. These two discoveries led to inventions, as I said, I'm repeating, electric generator, motor, transformers, electromagnets, and so on. So now let us come back to this linear motor on the table. Linear motor, or for that matter, any motor, whether DC or AC, works on the same principle or the same effect. The effect is, whenever a current-carrying conductor is placed in external magnetic field, that conductor will experience a force. And this force will make that conductor move. This is the basic principle behind the motors. This force that acts on the current-carrying conductor placed in magnetic field is called Lorentz force. There's a formula to calculate the magnitude of this force, but we will not go into the mathematics of this effect. We'll just stick to the concept, the basic concept that can explain the working of this linear motor. That's the focus of the video. What's interesting is the formula indicates that when the direction of the magnetic field and the current in that conductor are perpendicular to each other, the force on that conductor will be perpendicular to both of them. What this means is the directions of magnetic field, the electric current, and the force on the conductor will be mutually perpendicular to each other like this. Actually, these three stretched fingers indicate these three directions. This is a fantastic and superb trick used by Fleming. This is known as Fleming's left hand rule. These three fingers, they stretched out three fingers of left hand, which are perpendicular to each other, indicate the directions of force, current, and magnetic field. Now, how to know which finger indicates what direction? It's easy to remember. I remember it as FBI. I is the direction of the current in the conductor. B indicates the magnetic field or the direction of the magnetic field, and the thumb indicates the force that will be acting on the current carrying conductor placed in that magnetic field. Amazing. Fleming's left hand rule. So in this video, we are going to see the Lorentz force in action, and also we are going to make use of Fleming's left hand rule to predict in which direction the current carrying conductor on this setup will move. Let us have a closer look at this experiment setup. So this is the material required for linear motor. I've got two copper bars or copper strips, a thin copper cylinder, a DC power source, a current limiting resistor, push to on switch and two connecting clips, and this line of magnets. These magnets are pointing in the same direction. The north poles of each of them are pointing upwards, and because of this alignment, there's a lot of repulsion here. That's why I've stuck all these magnets between the two wooden battens using double-sided tape. If not for all that sticking, all these magnets will repel each other and just move apart. Let us assemble this linear motor. I'll place the copper bars on the wooden battens on either side of the magnets and connect the DC source. So now this side, or this copper strip, is negative and this is positive. I'll keep this copper cylinder right here in the center, and it's completing the loop. This copper cylinder is completing the loop, and this copper cylinder is going to be our current carrying conductor placed in external magnetic field. The direction of the current in this copper cylinder is going to be from red clip side to black clip side. And if you observe, the direction of the magnetic field and the direction of current are going to be perpendicular to each other. And as I said earlier, when the current in the conductor and the magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, the force on this conductor will be perpendicular to both. And how do we find the direction of perpendicular force? Again, bringing in Fleming's left hand rule. FBI. This indicates the direction of the current. This indicates the direction of magnetic field. F indicates the direction of force experienced by that current carrying conductor. And that's the direction in which this current carrying conductor will move. Let us apply Fleming's left hand rule to this situation. Let me align these fingers in the direction of magnetic field and current in this situation. So there we go. This is I, the direction of the current. There it is, the direction of the current from positive to negative. That's the direction of the current. This is going to indicate the direction of the magnetic fields. I will have to turn my fingers like this. So now, current, magnetic field, and the thumb shows the direction of the force that will act on this conductor. So it's going to be from left to right. Let us check that. Let me on the circuit, or let me send the current through this copper cylinder and watch what happens. Yeah, there it goes. Let me do that again. Showing it like this. Current, magnetic field, force. Super. Now let us reverse the polarity. I'll make this side positive, this side negative, and we'll repeat the experiment. And now, since the direction of the current is reversed, applying Fleming's left hand rule, this conductor should move from right to left. So here, now the direction of the current is reversed. This side is positive, this side is negative. So now the current is going to flow from this side of the copper cylinder to this side. We have just reversed the direction of the current. The direction of magnetic field is still the same. So let us bring in Fleming's left hand rule once again. FBI, this is the current, and this is the direction of the current right now, from positive to negative, and my forefinger should indicate the direction of the magnetic field, and the thumb will indicate the direction of the force and the direction in which this conductor will move once the current is sent through it. So let me send the current through the rod with the current reversed, and watch. It just rolled in the opposite direction. Earlier it rolled from left to right, and now it rolls from right to left. Wonderful. What we are going to do now is, I will revert to the original polarity of the current. I'll make this side positive, this side negative, but I'm going to flip the magnets. All the south poles are going to face upwards. And then let us see the movement of this current carrying conductor. Okay, so the current setup is back as the first setup. This side is positive, that side is negative. That means current is going to pass through this cylinder like this. And I have reversed the polarity of the magnets. All south poles are now pointing upwards. In this case now, the magnetic field is going to be directed downwards. So let us bring in Fleming's left hand rule again, FBI. Current, magnetic field, force. Let me align the fingers in the respective directions. This is the current, so aligning like that. This is the direction of the current. This will show the magnetic field, which is currently perpendicular into the plane of the magnets. And the thumb indicates the direction of the force and the direction in which that conductor should move. Let us send the current in the conductor and watch. There. Moves in the predicted direction, predicted by Fleming's left-hand rule. There it goes. Now, in this same situation, keeping the magnetic polarity same, I will invert the polarity of the current. So now, fourth and the last setup, the magnetic poles pointing upwards are still south poles. Now, I have reversed the direction of the current. Red or the positive is this side, negative is this side. So current is going to flow this way. That means the current is reversed. Now, if I apply Fleming's left-hand rule, I already know in which direction the force will act. That is from left to right, because earlier it moved from right to left. Let us send the current through the cylinder and watch that. Let me do this once again. There you go. Lorentz force in action and application of Fleming's left-hand rule. Very, very clever and thoughtful trick by Fleming. So let me explain this effect in a little more details. There is a magnetic field generated by the permanent magnets. This is the conductor that carries the current whenever the switch is put on. And Oersted had already demonstrated that a current carrying conductor generates a magnetic field. So when we send a current in this copper cylinder, it generates its own magnetic field. It has its own direction, and of course we can find out the direction of that magnetic field. There is a separate video again on that. So the magnetic field generated by this current carrying conductor and the magnetic field of the permanent magnets interact, and that generates the force called Lorentz force. That's how this linear motor works. Actually, that's how any motor works. Simple and wonderful linear motor. Why it's called linear? Because the motion of the conductor here is in straight line, and the magnetic field is also in straight line, that is perpendicular to the plane here, perpendicular to the electric current. If somehow I can turn this into a circular shape, I'll get a DC motor. All these magnets fitted into the body, circular body of a DC motor, and an armature carrying the windings inserted in this body. And whenever the current is passed in that armature, the opposite sides of, in fact, every conductor of that winding will experience same force, the Lorentz force, due to the magnetic field created by the magnets in the body. And the opposite sides of the coil will experience the forces in opposite directions, creating a torque, and that's how the armature rotates. I'll be making a separate video explaining the working of DC motor using a simple DC motor model that I've already built. Nature and natural phenomena are amazing, fascinating. And physics is the quest of learning these phenomena by digging deeper, by doing systematic study of these phenomena and revealing the secrets of nature. So if you have a curious mind and you want to learn more such secrets of nature, this is a secret of nature, electricity, magnetism, and myriad's other phenomena. If you want to learn about those amazing phenomena which are revealed by physics, keep watching the videos on my channel, like them, share them, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel.